visual experience. She may turn on the volume in her head with that scene, and she will raise the experience of the feeling with that scene, and she'll have an enriching experience with her.
So there is a primary and secondary operating.
Absolutely. So the primary mode of modality for you is visual. For some it is auditory, for some it is kinesthetic, and you operate from that. And when you know it now, then you will also know that there are other people also who will be having similar kind of modalities. Not similar to those that you have. You are an auditory person and she is a visual person. If you want to make her understand, you may fail or you may have to try hard if you start trying auditory techniques on her. Listen to me, I will tell you, she will not understand. This is not her style. Instead, when you know, if you know that she is a visual person, and then you say things like, okay, see, you know how it happens. When you imagine this, now you'll get to know about it, and then she's rightly connected with you. Because she'll start seeing those things. But now you can know that, yes, Sukhranjan is a visual person. Or Sukhranjan may know that Ankush is an auditory person. You may use your dialogues accordingly. What about the rest of people? We do not know now. I will not go ahead with this sheet with every person. Say, okay, first write it down and then I will tell you. He cannot do that. So then what is the catch to it? To be 100% having a connect with that person. What can we do? You have all the resources, I'm telling you. I have full belief in you. Please believe in yourself. Now you know that who all are visuals and auditories and kinesthetics. For the rest of the world, out of this room, we do not know. Then how will you operate with the other person whose modalities are unaware or hidden from you so that you can get the best result from that person? How can you do